My journey to this place today was a little atypical. I do have a son, and when it came to my attention that there were issues in the United States with gay men having babies, even adopting, it incited me because I was raised in a less than ideal home, and I thought, if two loving, amazing people want to be parents, who are you to stop them? So I thought, well, I can either pick it and fight, or I can just jump through those hoodles and do it myself. So that's what I did. I started looking at agencies, and I was rejected 3 times because the doctor who delivered my son didn't keep all of his records when he decided to move his practice. So I was rejected 3 times, and I thought, let me try on the internet. If it doesn't work, then it's just not meant to be, and I'll move on with my life and do something else. And that's where I met David. I also met some other couples, and we did an internet dating type thing, but it just didn't feel right. And when Art said, there's chemistry, there is chemistry, if it's right. And with other guys, they were super nice. They were great folks, but it just wasn't right. And with David, we just had this amazing chemistry. We would have these long conversations about nothing to do with fertility, about the baby. It was just this amazing relationship building. And honestly, that's the most important thing that we have. When we started this with both couples, we didn't intend to have what we have today. I needed to be able to trust them. If I knew this person, made this person, did everything right for a year for this little person, and handed this person over, I needed to trust that they would continue what I started. In the same respect, they put an amazing amount of trust in me. I can't imagine what that's like, to be that hands-off, to know that your baby's 1,000 miles away in somebody's belly. That's just amazing. And just the trust and the confidence that we had in one another is, that's just a silly word, but it's amazing. So the screening and matching is a little atypical than what you would do with one of these agencies. That said, we still had to go through the normal hurdles. You know, even though we've been talking for months, we still had to do the telephone conversation. Like, hello, how are you? Nice to meet you.
No last names.
No last names. but myself, my husband, David, Alex, we all had to play this dating game, and it was very odd because not only are you dating that couple, and then you go home and you chit chat, and you get together. What did he say? What did she say? But that said, it's amazing. It's just wonderful. Some challenges. I'm just going to jump around. You talked about the hospital. Depending on where your surrogate is, you will have issues that we couldn't have foreseen. At the first hospital where we had Flora, this was the first time they'd ever done anything like this. So we created some new hospital regulations. It took about a day meeting with this woman who was very bureaucratic and wanted things a very specific way. We had to bring in contracts and paperwork. At the very last minute with ASA, they did a hospital switch. My insurance did a hospital switch on us. So where we had set precedence at the first hospital, 8 months?
Yeah.
Eight and a half months. You know, he was almost here, and they said, oh, go to this other hospital.
A Catholic Baptist hospital
in the Bible Belt. So we freaked out, but it was actually a much better experience there because they had done this before. And they said, oh, here's the paperwork. We're used to this, no problem. We also had issues with birth certificates. Sometimes they wanted to put me as the mother in the hospital, the first hospital. They wanted me banded to the baby. So there are things that you just don't think about sometimes. What else? So much. Yeah, the hospital. There's just so much that you're not prepared to even think of.
We were both lucky in that both couples were roomed in the hospital, which was
yes.
Lovely.
Which will make all of your Manhattan friends jealous. Both had single rooms.
So I get asked a lot, well, don't you miss the baby? Don't you want the baby? Weren't you worried? Don't you know that makes you a bad mom if you didn't have that urge? And honestly, this is a joke between us. But I was concerned with David and Alex and Flora because there is this hormonal surge, this biological imperative to match with this kid so you don't leave it in the woods. So I was really concerned. And the whole time I was pregnant, every week we would talk, which I suggest you do. And I would say, oh, your daughter did this, and Flora did this, you know, just to make the psychological disconnect. But still, I was concerned. And then I had a dream. Do you know David Lynch, the racer head? So I had a dream that I birthed a baby. And that was all I needed. I was good. I knew there was not going to be a connection. That said, I was still concerned. So with the incredible doctor that we had, I told her, as soon as the baby's born, take the baby to the other room, just in case I freak out or anything happens. Well, birth Flora looked at her and said, it's a baby. It's not my baby. And I was fine. And there was no issue. And then the next day, David's partner said, do you want to hold her? And I said, okay, final test. And I held her and it was somebody else's baby. So, we're good. And so when it came time for Asa, I knew there wasn't going to be an issue with that wants. And there was a weepy day after Flora, and I think it was just hormones and it was the coulda coulda, but it was just one weepy day. And now when I see the kids, it's not there. It's a friend's child, but it's nice. And to have that connection, they send photos all the time. Cell phone photos. Sometimes I think if I printed them out, connected them, I could, make a flipbook run. So, but it's wonderful that we still have this connection. And as the kids get older, they might have questions. I'm here to answer their questions. If we see each other twice a year, maybe. So we're there. And I suggest that open relationship because you know how children are. They want to hear their story all the time. They have questions. How did I get here? Why did I get here like that? And just no secrets. It just makes it easier. Okay. I think I'm good.